Good morning, students. In this video, let us find the Fourier transform of a constant or a DC signal. Right. So the DC signal or constant, let us take K. To find the Fourier transform of this DC signal, we need to remember duality property of the Fourier transform. I am writing the statement of duality property here. See, we have two analysis for Fourier transform, x of f and x of omega. Both statements I am writing here. Let us find the Fourier transform of this constant in both analysis, x of f and x of omega both. First, x of f analysis, the duality property statement is like this. If x of t, Fourier transform x of f, then capital X of t, Fourier transform is small x of minus f. And if it is x of omega analysis, then the statement, same statement, if x of t Fourier transform x of omega, then capital X of t Fourier transform 2 pi small x of minus omega. Observe what is this statement means. Small x, capital X here, these are signals. And T, F, these are index, here time index, here frequency index, or this is independent variable here. This is also independent variable here. So here time domain, frequency domain, we are not changing the domains. Left hand side always time domain, right hand side also always frequency domain. We are just exchanging the signals from frequency domain to time domain. So correspondingly, the signal from time domain to frequency domain, it goes with reflection here. If it is omega analysis, the reflected signal in this frequency domain is multiplied with extra 2 pi. That is what the statement we can easily remember. So with the help of this statement, let us find the Fourier transform of this constant. And along with this statement, let us recall the Fourier transform of the delta function. Already we have derived the Fourier transform of delta function, that is equal to 1. Let us consider the Fourier transform pair, del of t Fourier transform 1. Here and here I am considering the Fourier transform pair. So here impulse function Fourier transform is a DC signal. 1 is a constant DC signal we can consider. So 1 if I take this side, that means according to the duality property, we are exchanging the signals. So 1, if I take this side, obviously this delta function goes that side with reflection. So del of minus f, we have to write. Similarly here, 1, if I take this side, del of t goes to that side with reflection and 2 pi multiplied. So 2 pi del of minus omega. We know the symmetry property of the impulse function. Symmetry property of del of t says that del of minus t is equal to del of t. So that we can write this del of minus f as del of f. So 1 Fourier transform del of f. Here 1 Fourier transform 2 pi del of omega. We want the Fourier transform of constant. So from the homogeneity property or linearity property, we can multiply both sides with constant k. So k constant, Fourier transform here it is, k into del of f, and k constant in this Fourier transform is 2 pi k del of omega. So very important Fourier transform pair, this one. This Fourier transform of constant is used in the finding the Fourier transform of unit step function. So we need to remember this one there. Thank you.